very warm welcome to all you amazing learners to India's largest online learning application, Unacademy. Today's chapter that we are going to discuss is Tansen. It is chapter number 5 from your book, The Honeycomb. And welcome to my class, dear learners. My name is Sweksha Sahai and I am your English educator. I'm extremely passionate about learning and teaching English. Apart from English, I also know two other foreign languages, which are French and Spanish. So you can say that overall, I am very passionate about languages. That was a little bit about me. And now let's understand the wonders that you can do with the Unacademy app. You can ace your school with Unacademy, and now you can get the plus subscription at a flat 10% discount if you use my code SWS10. The Unacademy app is amazing, guys, so go ahead and download it and enjoy all the things that the app can give to you. There are many free things that are available on the app as well. There are free special classes, there are free test series on the application. You can get your doubts answered. So why don't we go ahead and join the app today? All right, so with that, let's begin the chapter for today, which is Tansen, chapter number 5. You may have heard the name of Tansen, the greatest musician our country has produced. A singer called Mukundan Mishra and his wife lived in Behat near Gwalior. Tansen was their only child. It is said that he was a naughty child. Often he ran away to play in the forest and soon learnt to imitate perfectly the calls of birds and animals. So what do we know from this paragraph? We know that Tansen was the only child of a musician who was known as Mukundan Mishra, and he lived in Gwalior. Also, Tansen was a naughty but very intelligent child, because he would run to the jungles and there he learned to imitate the calls of animals. A famous singer named Swami Haridas was traveling through the forest with his disciples. Tired, the group settled down to rest in a shady grove. Tansen saw them. "Strangers in the forest," he said to himself. "It will be fun to frighten them." He hid behind a tree and roared like a tiger. The little group of travelers scattered in fear, but Swami Haridas called them together. "Don't be afraid," he said. "Tigers are not always dangerous. Let's look for this one." Suddenly, one of his men saw a small boy hiding behind a tree. "There are no tigers here, master," he said. "Only this naughty boy." So Swami Haridas was able to find Tansen and his mischief. What did he do? He tried to scare the travelers, the band of musicians, by imitating a tiger. But Swami Haridas caught him. Now what happens next? Let's see. So Swami Haridas did not punish him. He went to Tansen's father and said, "Your son is very naughty. He is also very talented. I think I can make him a good singer." So Swami Haridas was not a man who would get angry very easily, is what we can see. Many other people might get very angry on a boy like this and may not teach him. But Swami Haridas, on the other hand, was a very wise man. He knew the talent that Tansen had. So he decided to take Tansen under his tutelage, and he decided to tutor Tansen to become a great singer. So Tansen was 10 years old when he went away with Swami Haridas. He lived with him for 11 years, learning music, and became a great singer. At about this time, his parents died. Mukundan Mishra's dying wish was that Tansen should visit Mohammad Ghose of Gwalior. Mohammad Ghose was a holy man. Mukundan Mishra had long been devoted to him and often visited him. So this holy man was revered by Tansen's father, and it was his dying wish, his last wish, that Tansen should visit Mohammad Ghose. So when Tansen visited Mohammad Ghose, we will see what happened there. So Tansen was often taken to the court of Rani Mrignani by Mohammad Ghose, who was a great musician herself. There he met and married one of the ladies of the court. Her name was Husseini. So Tansen and Husseini got married. who was a lady in the court of Queen Mrignani, Rani Mrignani. Husaini also became Swami Haridas's disciple. So even Husaini became a singer with Swami Haridas. Tansen and Husaini had 5 children who were all very musical. Tansen had by this time become very famous. So he had of course grown into a very famous singer and he had 5 children with Husaini. Sometimes he sang before the emperor, who was surprised by him, that he was so impressed by him that he insisted that Tansen should join his court. So Akbar was extremely impressed and he wanted Tansen to join his court, which is a great offer, and no singer or nobody can refuse an offer like that if a king himself makes this offer. So Tansen of course was very happy to get this offer and he joined Akbar's court in 1556, and soon he became the favorite singer of Akbar. Akbar would call upon Tansen to sing at any time during the day or night. Quite often he would just walk into Tansen's house to hear him practice. So Akbar was such a huge fan of Tansen that he would not leave Tansen alone at all. Okay, sometimes he would just walk into Tansen's house just to see him practice. So he gave him many presents. Some of the courtiers became jealous of Tansen. We shall never be able to rest till Tansen is ruined, they declared. One of the courtiers, Shaukat Mia, had a bright idea. So, as always, people become jealous of someone who's becoming famous, who's becoming the king's favorite. So, this Shaukat Mia had an idea. Let's see what this idea was. So, let us make him sing Rag Deepak, he said. How will that help us? Asked another man. If Rag Deepak is sung properly, it makes the air so hot that the singer is burnt to ashes. Tansen is a very good singer. If he sings Rag Deepak, he will die and we will be rid of him. So this was his evil plan. He wanted Tansen to sing Rag Deepak, which makes the air very hot. And he wanted that Tansen dies in this process. So Shaukat Mia went to Akbar and said, we don't think Tansen is a great singer. Let us test him. Tell him to sing Rag Deepak. Only the greatest singers can sing it properly. So he instigated Akbar to make Tansen sing Rag Deepak, which is a dangerous rag because he was jealous of Tansen. Of course he can sing it. Tansen can sing anything, said Akbar. Tansen was afraid but could not disobey the king. Very well, my lord, but give me time to prepare myself. Tansen went home. He had never been more downcast and unhappy. To be downcast means to be dull and sad. I can sing the rag, he told to his wife, but the heat it gives off will not only set the lamps alight, it will also burn me to ashes. So Tansen was very well aware of the dangers that singing Rag Deepak can bring him. Then he had a bright idea. If someone sings Rag Megh at the same time, and if it is sung properly, it will bring rain. Perhaps our daughter Saraswati and her friend Rupvati could do it, he said. He taught the two girls to sing Rag Megh. They practiced night and day for 2 weeks. Tansen told them, you must wait till the lamps start burning and then you should start singing the Rag Megh. So Tansen, who was very talented since his childhood, okay, he decided to and he was also very wise, so he decided that he should make his daughters learn the Rag Megh so that they are able to sing it at the time that he is singing Rag Deepak, which would save him from dying because of the heat. The legend goes that on the appointed day, the whole town assembled to hear Tansen sing Rag Deepak. When he began to sing, the air became warm. Soon, people in the audience were bathed in perspiration. Perspiration means sweat, pasina. The leaves on the trees dried up and fell to the ground. As the music continued, birds fell dead because of the heat, and the water in the rivers began to boil up. People cried out in terror as flames shot out of nowhere and lighted the lamps. So, as we have said previously, that Rag Deepak could light lamps, and that's exactly what happened. At once, Saraswati and Rupati began to sing Rag Megh. The sky clouded over and the rain came down. Tansen was saved. The story goes that he was very ill after this, and Akbar was sorry that he had caused him so much suffering. He punished Tansen's enemies. When Tansen got well, the entire city rejoiced. Tansen remained Akbar's court singer till 1585, when he died. He composed several new ragas. Tansen's tomb is in Gwalior. It is a place of pilgrim for local for musicians. So we see that Akbar loved him so much that he punished the people who had done this, who were behind this. But Tansen had become really ill after singing the Rag Deepak. Even though he was saved, he had fallen severely ill. Now let's look at the questions one by one. So why did Swami Haridas call Tansen talented? Swami Haridas called Tansen talented because he could imitate a tiger to perfection. You can go back to the incident in the jungle in your book. Why did Akbar ask Tansen to join his court? Akbar liked Tansen's voice a lot, and that is why he asked the great singer to join his court. How do we know that Akbar was fond of Tansen? Give reasons. So Akbar invited Tansen to be a member of his court. He also punished the enemy of Tansen who had conspired to make him sing the Rag Deepak. These are the reasons why we can say that Akbar was fond of Tansen. What did the other courtiers feel about Tansen? So we have said in the chapter previously that the other courtiers felt extremely jealous of Tansen's growing popularity and his closeness to the great king Akbar. What happens if Rag Deepak is sung properly? So we've seen in the book that if Rag Deepak heats the environment if sung properly, so much so that the singer burns and dies at the end due to the heat produced by this raga. Why did Tansen's enemies want him to sing Rag Deepak? Tansen's enemies wanted him to sing Rag Deepak so that he burns and dies on his own. This would serve their purpose because they don't really have to get their hands dirty to kill the great singer. So they conspired to make him sing the Rag Deepak. Why did Tansen agree to sing Rag Deepak? Tansen agreed to sing Rag Deepak as he could not say no to Akbar. Because we see that Akbar and Tansen had great friendship and Akbar had a lot of regard for Tansen. So Tansen could never say no to the great emperor. What steps did he take? He knew that Rag Deepak could kill him, but if someone sang Rag Megh properly, then it would start raining and he will be saved. So he trained his daughter and her friend to sing it when the lamps light up due to the heat of Rag Deepak. So this was Tansen's great plan to save himself. Did his plan work? Yes, his plan worked and he did not die, but he still fell very ill due to the heat of Rag Deepak. So that brings us to the end of this chapter, but let's look at the amazing features of the Unacademy's Plus a subscription, which is available to you at a 10% discount if you use my code SWS10. So download the app today and get on the app and get this amazing subscription for yourself. You can learn from mentors in live classes. There's a regular doubt clearing and answer writing sessions. There is an exhaustive coverage of your entire syllabus. Mentorship and guidance is available. Study material is available in PDF format. You get practice tests, you get live test series and batch courses. What else do you need? But there is definitely a lot more. So Unacademy pricing, Unacademy subscription pricing is mentioned on the screen right now. As I told you, you can use my code SWS10 and get a flat 10% discount on all of these prices. And now let's look at the Unacademy's iconic subscription features. So in iconic subscription, you get all the subscription features of the Plus subscription which we just spoke about earlier. Plus, you also get personal mentorship, which means you are assigned a mentor who will look after your performance and your development. You also get live doubt solving, which means you can ask your doubt anytime and get the answer there and then. There is weekly report, there is parent connect, which means your parents get to know exactly how much you have improved. There is a study planner and of course all the benefits of the plus subscription. The pricing is mentioned on the screen. You can go for it and use my code SWS10 to get a flat 10% discount. So go for it today. Well, that brings us to the end of this session, but do like, share and subscribe to our channel and do not forget to press the bell icon so that you don't miss any chapters from us. So that's it from my side today, but I'll be back very soon with a new chapter. Until then, take care of yourselves and I'll see you soon. Bye bye guys.